Lisa, I'm Dean, and I'm doing this project called IdeaBank. It's the application for the iPhone, how to store your ideas, inspiration. So just a little bit recap of what I talked about last time. So in the beginning of the project, I was doing a lot of like brainstorming, deciding what you, the functionalities would be in this application. So, what's this here, the function? So in the beginning of the project, I was able to make this code data model, the Xcode. And I worked out some model for the use. And I did some research about like how to visualize data. Different ways it could look and different technology you could use. So a lot happened since then. I developed the model for the use further. So just here the first one would be a text input and would be a list. So it all works in there. A tab bar, so there will be five different views to choose from. And the first one is you put in an idea again, and it automatically shows you where you are when you're typing the idea, and what's the date, the time. So you put in the idea title, text, and text, and you can add it, and it will be stored in the database. After you say it, go to the second tab here. You can see all the ideas that they were able to show and the sections. And you'll be able to use an index explorer to go to different sections. And then scroll after, show after, effectively the time. So the tentacles when you tap one cell here, it will go to a model view, and here it should show the details. So the first tab bar should be able to search the database for ideas. So the intention here is you can see where you got the different ideas. The last one is this one is a screenshot shot from a standalone from the library called Plot. And this I have implemented in my application. And my intention is to do something like this. Here's the list of all the ideas, and you can go to the index and change to a specific idea. So the first two tabs here is actually the views you can work the most with. The third one is search.
The search for RCOS?
Yeah, and this one is not working. It didn't work too much with this. The other took more time than I expected. So the fourth one is just show that something like this at one, just the ideas, this just shows the work right now. And the last one is the graph. So when I started this project, I'm not in computer science or anything, so it's been a challenging experience for me to build this. Very interesting as well. To learn about other things that come from a more design background. So maybe this has been more my focus. So I like some things to look nice interface and stuff like this. And the more challenging part is for me the programming. But actually through this project I really learned a lot about different frameworks in the used in Excel. And some of this was first of all the core data. And I realized when I got into this, it's not the most easy part to start with actually, but it was interesting to work with it now. And then I decided to work with Tape New. It was not actually my initial plan. I wanted just to visualize the data, where do you put in the idea. But when I was getting into it, I realized actually it's a good idea to work with this first, because I could learn from working with the Tape New and put that experience onto the other frameworks. So we worked with it in the Mac kit, and I did, as I showed in the beginning, and it's a research how to visualize the data. And I chose this hot plot framework because it was easy to implement. Done that and I'm not really there when I'm working with the data. Then something I found was interesting, I made a plan for the project and so on. And you can have an intention about how everything is. And I've been doing a lot of other design projects, but not specific software. So I learned about the process as well going. And I see lots of iterations. So you make some interface, you try to interact with it, you find out actually it's not the best, so you try something else. So these two, the schedule. So I did expect this was a tentative schedule when I made it, because I didn't have experience with this kind of programming. So I did not know the technology, like the design process of it. So I'm not really there as I scheduled, but I really feel that I learned a lot, and actually I'm motivated to work on with this. So this is my last presentation before I go back to Denmark. So I thought I would say something about the whole learning process of doing it. So given that I had a design perspective, I see I had a different way of seeing things than if you are from the technology perspective. Because when I got into the technology and the software and so what can you do? Then you see different ways. You see maybe an easier way of doing things, but it doesn't look the best. So this has always been a struggle for me, right? Part of me wants things to look good, and the other part wants things to function. So it's a compromise.
And you're also doing this project all by yourself, right?
Yes.
So it's a Peter, a little bit,
yeah.
Anyway, you're doing it by yourself, so it's a big time.
Yeah, and I realized actually as well that at part of the process you can have an idea in your head, this is how I want things to look, but when you make it and you can interact with it, it's not exactly necessarily the best way. Then I learned about something about the complexity of the applications, because I realized the technology platform is you can have things that's rather complex, but compared to other programs and other things you can do with software, Yeah, and then the last part is, but I'm getting this. You have a picture of your head, and it's not necessarily the way it comes out of it. But, thank you for listening. And I would also like to say, because it's my last day here, that it's been very interesting to be a part of this research group, listen to other people's projects, and for myself, it's a learning experience to get to work on something like this for a long time.
Part will be hard. In your case, the design part you are good at, but the technology is.
Yes.
Any other questions? Thanks again.